अच्छा मैं ऐसे ना
यस डार्लिंग कम ऑन.
द बेस्ट वे टू फाइंड योर सेल्फ इज टू लूज योर सेल्फ इन द सर्विस ऑफ अदर्स.
वेरी गुड ब्यूटिफुल. इन द सर्विस ऑफ अदर्स लाइक कायद डिड ही रेंडर्ड हिज सर्विसेज टू अदर्स द बेस्ट वे टू स्पेंड द लाइफ. वेरी गुड ब्यूटिफुल. एनीवन एल्स? एनीवन एल्स? यू म्यूट योरसेल्फ नाउ. Don't be sad that it's over by happy that it happened. Well done. Anyone else?
Excuse me, teacher.
Yes.
Teacher, may I say?
Yes, Pita. Come on, come on. I want to refresh you. Come on.
Successful people have two things. First, smile and the silence.
Beautiful. Wonderful. Why to wish star? Come on again. Beautiful. Thank you, Beta. Thank you. Wonderful. Can I share now? Sir, can you just better zoom your picture and see. I am going to share the page of my diary. Look at the beautiful poem of Allama Iqbal. Oh, beautiful choice. Choose the best if you have no. Wonderful. I'm very happy, girls. I want the same response from the boys' side. Tomorrow, boys, gentlemen, it's your turn. Now, it's my turn that I will... Luckily, I got this beautiful poem. See, what is the date written? History is full of dates. What is the date written, Beta, on my poem? Come on, come on, write it. Yes, Menahil, thank you. The best way to predict your future is to create it. You are creating your future. Yes, Hamna, thank you. It is 6th August. It means that 2017, I wrote this in my diary. It's the poem. Thank you, thank you. It's the poem by Allama Iqbal. Anyone love to read or shall I read? Now just watch. It is related. Allama Iqbal kept on pushing the Muslims to stand up, work and educate yourself. Now he has imposed a beautiful spirit among the Muslims. Koi aruj de na zawal de, mujhe sirf itna kamal de. मुझे अपने राह में डाल दे के जमाना मेरी मसाल दे. तेरी रहमतों का नजूल हो, मुझे मेहनतों का सिला मिले. मुझे माल और सर की हवस नहीं, मुझे बस तू रिज़्क हलाल दे. मेरे जहन में तेरी फिकर हो, मेरी सांस में तेरा जिक्र हो. तेरा खौफ मेरी नजात हो, सभी खौफ दिल से निकाल दे. तेरी बारगाह में ए खुदा, मेरी रोज और शब है यही दुआ. तू रहीम है, तू करीम है, मुझे मुश्किलों से निकाल दे. ब्यूटिफुल वर्ड्स ऑफ अल्लामा इकबाल. इफ यू गेट टाइम, राइट इट इन योर डायरी. सो सर, थैंक यू फॉर शेयरिंग दिस स्क्रीन. वेलकम यू ऑल डार्लिंग. यस्टरडे आई रिक्वेस्टेड यू एंड आई टोल्ड यू बेटा, गो थ्रू द पैराग्राफ. द बेस्ट वे इज दैट व्हाटसोएवर इज given to you in one lecture, try just in the evening, just take 2 minutes or 5 minutes to recall that lesson. Very good. Thank you, Beta. So how many of you have done the reading of that paragraph? Yesterday we read about the Qaid's life. Little introduction about Qaid was given on page number 46. Quickly take your pencils in your hands. The next screen is going to give you the MCQs. A just review of your yesterday's lesson. Sir, can you share the screen? Take your pencils in your hands, Beta. Yes. Take 2 minutes. Can you read out the MCQs? 8 MCQs are there. 7 MCQs are there. Can you read out? This is the review, Beta. Good. Just write the answers. We are going to check that one. Good. I will give you 2 minutes to check the best answer, to find the best answer. Sir, check whether they are reading or not. Look at the boys also. Take help from the book. You can take help from the book also. Done? Okay, I will repeat the slide. First is about Kaidyasam compel. Kaidyasam Gandhi compelled British to partition. No, wait. I will throw the question. I have a list of the kids. Kaidyasam birthplace, Sialkot or Karachi. At the age of 10, Kaidyasam was sent to school where? Mumbai, Karachi. Lincoln's Inn University is where? America or London? Kaidyasam joined Muslim League when? 1906, 1913. Lord Minto, Kaidyasam was the first Governor General. Kaidyasam died in this year, 1948-1949. Now, I will ask the kids. I have got the list. Now, I'm going to ask the first question. Unmute yourself, Abdul Rafi. What is the answer of the first MCQ? Turn on Abdul Rafi. If you are there, turn on the mic. Abdul Rafi, are you there? Speak loudly. Kaidyasam. Is it correct, kiddies? Good. Very good. The rest must turn off the mic. Now, Nabeel Khan, it's your turn. Kaidyasam birthplace. Turn on the mic, you can speak.
Karachi.
Turn on the mic. Very good. Karachi. Very good. Thank you, beta. Now,
excuse me, teacher.
The Bushra Anjuman.
Excuse me, teacher. Sir, John ki side se mic on hai. Tum main unable unhe mute karne ke liye. Sir John, please switch. Sir John,
unmute your mic. Nikhil, can't you do it yourself?
Teacher, मैं उनका नाम मुझे मिल नहीं रहा, लेकिन मेरे पास उनका आ रहा है.
Monitor. Yes. Sir John, please unmute. Oh my God, the whole conversation is there. Call him.
John,
sir John,
मैं वो करके तो साइड पे हो गए तो लगे हुए हैं.
Second last पे हैं सर जॉन.
एक मिनट में ये स्क्रीन ऑफ कर रहा हूँ टीचर थोड़ी देर के लिए.
Okay. Now he has done. Shall I continue? Screen the share yes. The screen, sir. Kids, are you happy with this activity? It's just the review, beta, recap of your lesson. So, Bushra Ajmal, screen. Bushra Ajmal, beta, turn on your mic only. At the age of 10, Kaidyasam was sent where? It's Ramin Sohotra. Are you present, beta? Ramin, answer me for. Hurry up, turn on the mic, beta. Ramin. Okay, Sahreem, are you present, beta? Sahreem, can you hear me? Answer this question. Lincoln's Inn University is where?
London.
Well done. Kaidyasam joined Muslim League when? 1906-1913. 1913 or 1906. It's Mohib Waris. I'm just pulling the boys. I know that the girls are present. I would like to get the answer from the boys. Mohib, what is the correct answer for MCQ 5?
So 1913.
Very good. 1913. Very good. 1913. Lord Minto, Kaidyasam was the first governor. Who was the first governor of Pakistan? Oliver Shakil. Hurry up. Who was the first? Turn on the mic, beta. Who was the first governor general? Angel Fiaz, are you present, beta? Answer this MCQ. Who was the first
teacher
governor
Kaidyasam.
General?
Kaidyasam.
Very good. Thank you, darling. Kaidyasam died in the year. What was the year? 1948-1949. Rabia Lisan.
She can hear
Speak
me.
Up, beta. Yes, I can hear you, darling.
1948.
Well done. This was the quick review of your previous day lesson. Now, turn on the page. Take up the page 47 on your books, pencils in your hands. And Shakil, I would like to request you just keep an eye on the kids, whether they are doing this thing or not. I trust my kids. and I do believe that they are taking in. Take your pencils in your hands, Peta. Now, first point, I told you yesterday that guides rendered his services. There are many. It's page number 47, sir. Page next slide. Page 47. Yes. Now, under Lucknow Pact, Qaid-e Azam united both of the nations. Who united both of the nations? Qaid-e Azam. Now, remember that each and every sentence has got the information and dates and the events and the places. You need to circle all those because they will help you to solve the MCQs. Which, what was the pact? Kaunsa maida tha? Misake Lucknow. Muahida ka matlab, pact means muahida, misak. So Lucknow pact, Qaid-e Azam united both. What? Both the nations. What were the both nations? Means Hindus and Muslims. The Hindus and the Muslims, it is in the bracket. When in 1916, when was the pact signed? Lucknow pact was signed in 1916. And I'll circle the 1916. He got the right of separate electorates. What right? What was the right? Kaun sa haq mila tha? Separate electorates. Now you will ask me, what is separate electorate? Separate electorate means the right of the minorities that they can select their own representative. Isme ye tha ki agar ek ilake mein ek Hindu hai aur ek Musliman hai, to Musalmanon ke paas, ya minorities ke paas, ya Sikhon ke paas, ye haq ho jata tha ki wo apna numainda chun sakte the. So earlier jo tha wo ye tha ki zahiri baat tha, it was Hindus were in majority, so Muslims were lacking their representatives in their meetings. So unhone ye demand ki Lucknow pact mein, that in 1916 Lucknow pact, Qaid-e Azam stood with the right of the separate electorate for the Muslims, and it was acknowledged. Isko maan bhi liya gaya, and for this purpose he got the title of ambassador of peace. Aman ke safir. Ambassador of peace means aman ke safir. So this is very important in the history of Pakistan, that in 1916, in under the Lucknow pact, separate electorates right for the Muslims was, or for the minorities was accepted. Is that clear? Each and every point has a history, beta, so listen carefully. The next point is, second point is, he along with the Hindu is, N is missing, H-I-N-D-U. It's Hindu written, but N is missing. He along with Hindu leader Gokhale. Gokhale demanded new constitutional reforms. What is constitutional? What is constitutional? Aini. Reforms mean Islahat. So he demanded that bring change in those in the constitution in 1913. So when it was happened, reforms were revised. Agar jo koi change lana chahte hain, it was, they brought change in that one. When? So circle the year 1913. And again in 1919, his efforts for the Montague Chelmsford are of the great significance. Now who was Montague Chelmsford? Montague Chelmsford was the Viceroy of India, right on the date 1916 to 1921. This is an extra knowledge I am providing you. Montague Chelmsford was the Viceroy 1916 to 1921. Whose mic is working again? Shakil, check please. New constitutional reforms were introduced again. From again, the second point. He, along with Hindu leader Gokhale, demanded new constitutional reforms. Now, see that Qaid is continuously working with the Hindus also, trying to bring peace. So he demanded the constitutional reforms. From whom he asked this one? The Viceroy of India, Montague Chelmsford. Yes. And Montague Chelmsford was the Viceroy of India from the year 1916 till 1921. Then, remember that, Peter, I would like to add in your knowledge, during the period of Viceroy of India, Montague Chelmsford, Lucknow Pact was signed, then Jallianwala Bagh incident happened, then Khilafat movement, and then non cooperation movement, and then role tact. Now let me explain the story behind Jallianwala Bagh. Jallianwala Bagh was a place in Amritsar. Sikh during the Baisakhi period, April 13th is the day when all the Punjabi people, or in Punjab, people go for the harvesting of their wheat crop. उसके लिए वो सारे लोग वहां पर जलियांवाला बाग में इकट्ठे थे. किसी के पास कोई वेपन नहीं था, और उसमें ये हुआ था कि they demanded, a very peaceful protest was going on, and they demanded कि दो उनके लीडर्स को पकड़ा गया तो उन्हें छोड़ दिया जाए. So they were not holding the weapon, as celebration was going on, and many people were gathered there. General O'Dwyer, he was a general, and he opened the fire on the peaceful people. 400 people died in that, 1,000 people injured. But because you know that in those days, people were not allowed to go for the gathering, but they gathered there and they want to celebrate the April 13, the harvesting season. Plus, they were demanding to release the two arrested people. So he opened, and that is the story behind Jallianwala Bagh. So this case and this incident was happened during the period of Champ 4 period. So I would like to say that one. Now I'm coming to the point three. In 1919, Sir Sidney Rolt got an act passed. It was named as the Rolt Act. It was a black law. I'm telling you, during the Champs 4, this law was passed. Now when it was passed, year 1919, who passed this law? Sir Sidney Rolt. And it was the black law. Why it was called the black law, Bitter? Because during this act, police was given the right to arrest a person without any complaint. Agar wo logon ko pakad lete the, so they were not allowed to go for the court or the trial or to hire a lawyer. So this was called the black law. Who called it a black law? The administration. Let me tell you, the administration was given unlimited powers and the civil rights were trodden upon. Kisko zyada power de di gayi? Administration ko. And civil rights means shahri hukuk. Trodden upon, kuchal diye gaye. They were not given. And what was the civil right? That if somebody is arrested, has a right to hire a lawyer and go for the trial. But this was trodden upon. Isko kuchal diya gaya. And Kai raised his voice against it. And he wrote to the Viceroy Champs 4. What did he write? In my opinion, the government that passes or sanctions manzoor karti hai. Such a law in the times of peace forfeits his claim. Kabil nahi hai claim karne ke to be called a civilized government. Now I'm going to tell you the meaning of this sentence. Qaid said, main mehsoos karta hoon ke hukumat samane aman mein aise kanoon ko manzoor karti, wo sanction wala word aa gaya, wo mahazab hukumat kehlane ka haq nahi rakhti. Why he said that it was the zamane aman or peaceful environment thi? Kyunki wahan tab koi aisa jhagda nahi chal raha tha. So jab ye kanoon pass hua, to what happened? Unrest position came. People got disturbed because people were arrested by the police. Administration ke paas rights zyada ho gaye aur logon ko trial ya mukadma bazi ka mauka nahi mil raha tha. Am I clear regarding to this point? So remember, when it was passed, 1919, who was the person? Sir Sidney Rolt. And who called this black law? Qaid wrote, gave this the black law. And please remember, make it a short question. What was the opinion of Qaid against the Rolt Act? Make a short question, write it on your book. Short question. Who said it is a black law? Who said? It's a black law, Qaid said. And then you need to learn the Qaid's words. In my opinion, this is the answer of that question. Am I clear? Now, number 4 point. In Delhi Muslim Proposals. Now, Delhi Muslim Proposals, when? 1927. Jo tha ye, Delhi Muslim Proposal, 1927, Qaid withdrew the right. Withdrew ka matlab? Khatam kar liya ya wapas de liya, right of separate electorate, and gave an indication to cooperate with the Congress but it could not be fulfilled. 1927, Delhi Muslim proposal diye gaye. Isme Qaid is trying to create the environment of peace. He was trying to cooperate. So he took back the what was decided in 1916, the separate election. He said, okay, let's work together. So Qaid continuously is trying to create the environment of the peace. So he rejected Nehru report in 1928. Now, fifth point is he rejected with a separate electorate ka matlab maine bataya tha, aap apne liye namainda chun sakte hain. Electorate means during election. Ye wo right tha minorities ko diya gaya ki aap majority ilake mein aap apna namainda jo hai wo chun sakte hain, aap apne namainde ko elect kar sakte hain. Is that clear? That was the right given to the minorities and that was accepted. Black law means aisa kanoon jisme law black means you know the law black ho jata hai, it means aisa kala kanoon, aisa kanoon jisme kisi ko fayda nahi hota. Aur isme kis kon log pis rahe the? Muslims were, minorities were, their rights were trodden upon. Right kya tha, kya haq tha unke paas कि वो किसी भी केस में अगर उनके ऊपर कोई इल्जाम लगता है तो दे हैव अ राइट टू हायर अ लॉयर, एक लॉयर को वो अपने लिए चुन सकते थे ताकि वो उसका मुकदमा लड़ सके. सो दैट इज द पॉइंट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. इज दैट क्लियर नाउ? देन इज द फिफ्थ पॉइंट, ही रिजेक्टेड नेहरू रिपोर्ट. हु रिजेक्टेड नेहरू रिपोर्ट? ऑन ही राइट ऑन द वर्ड Qaid. Qaid रिजेक्टेड नेहरू रिपोर्ट व्हाट इन 1928. When was the Nehru report was given? In 1928. And presented his 14 points in 1929. Who gave 14 points? Qaid's 14 points. And in your new book, 14 points are added. But I will tell you how to learn. So who rejected Nehru report? If I say Nehru report was issued in when? 1928. And when it was, Qaid gave 14 points? 1929, which determined the goals of the Muslim. Now, what was in the Nehru report? The most important point was the joint electorate. It is not written here, but to make this point clear to you, beta, I'm telling you, in Nehru report 1928, point was read that joint electorate should be there. Joint electorate means milka namainda chunna. And in the 14 points, Qaid stressed upon the separate electorate that the right should be given Muslims or Sikhs and the others Parsis, those who were minorities among the Hindu majority. The point was given, the right he demanded was the separate electorate, that it should be given that they have a right to choose their own representative in the majority areas of the Hindus. Am I clear? So, point raised in 1928 Nehru report, joint electorate. You can write it on Nehru report, joint electorate. And what was in the 14 points? The stress was given separate electorate for the minorities. Write it on the points, beta. Nehru report, joint electorate, and 14 points, 1929. I will just put the date here on the fifth point that we read till 5 points. What is the date? 7 May. Put it today because my time is up now and I will continue that one. A quick review of your lesson. Lucknow Pact, Qaid united the both the nations and he won the title of Ambassador of the Peace. Then in 1919, constitutional reforms were introduced with the help of Gokhale, the Hindu leader, 1913. And in 1919, Chelmsford reforms were introduced. Chelmsford was the Viceroy of India. Then Black Law was there, 1919, Rolt Act was passed. And then in Qaid Azam demanded that it's not a good law, it cannot be, it's a black law. Then Delhi Muslim proposal 1927, then again Nehru report was rejected Nehru Report was given in 1928 and 14 points of Kaif 1929. Nehru Report was for joint electorate. Kaif stressed in 1929, 14 points in his 14 points for the separate electorate. Up till here, beta, any question right now you can ask. I still have a 1 point, or if things are clear to you, read these 5 points again in your free time, and I will make another short MCQs, or maybe the fill in the blanks, or maybe the short question. Things are, I'm happy, beta. I'm happy myself. Things are clear to you? Good. If there is any query, any question, beta, things are not clear to you, you have the group chat in your person. Thank you, darling. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Okay. Things are clear to you? Happy? And tomorrow is boys' turn.